Staycations may not be what we were hoping for. Tight budgets and current events can put a damper on travel plans. Create an A-frame cabana and you can at least pretend your backyard is an exotic getaway. You'll need a close-boarded pallet. This one has no gaps for chair legs, fruity drinks, or cell phones to fall through. My pallet measures 38.5 by 50 inches and all of my measurements will be based on this. 6 pressure-treated 2x4s and 30 1x6x6 dog-eared fence pickets. 2 3.5-inch door hinges, a miter saw, safety glasses, a drill, bits for pilot holes and for screws, and measuring tape. 4-inch, 3-inch, and 1.5-inch screws. These should be rated for outdoor use. A step stool and a level. Spray paint. I'm using Rustoleum's new Solstice Blue for a breezy coastal vibe. First, set your pallet where you plan to build your cabana and ensure it sits level on the ground. If your pallet has a longer side, use that for the entrance. That means my 50-inch side will be the front. Attach one leaf of a hinge to the other end of a 2x4 with the accompanying screws. Line a second 2x4 up straight and attach the other side of the hinge. Follow this process again for 2 more 2x4s and the other hinge. Measure the height of your pallet's corner block. Mine is about 4 inches. Make a mark on your 2x4's base at the same height so you know where you can secure the A-frame in with screws. Drill 2 pilot holes into your 2x4 within that marking. I'm making one at about 1.5 inches up and the other at about 3 inches up. Since the 2x4s will sit at a slight angle, make the pilot holes at an angle as well. Bailey didn't want to hold the A-frame upright, so I bore these pilot holes while the 2x4s were on the ground. If you've got a more willing helper to hold the frame, it might be easier to gauge the angle as you drill. Set the A-frame upright and run 2 4-inch screws into each hole. Use a level to ensure the 2x4s are straight. Do this on all 4 legs of the A-frame. Cut 4 2x4s to serve as braces between the A-frame legs. These should be the same length as the shorter side of the pallet, 38.5 inches in my case. 2 of these will be attached to the bottom inside. Drill pilot holes and screw in place on both sides with the 3-inch screws. The remaining 2 will go about 2/3 up on the A-frame. Use a level to ensure these upper support boards are attached straight. Next, cut your fence pickets. You can cut these either the same length as your shorter side or add an inch or so for a little extra border. Secure a picket to the very top of one side of the A-frame with the 1.5-inch screws. Leave a little space and add another. Do this for 2 more pickets after that. These spaces will allow airflow from the top and for heat to escape. I attached these spaced pickets so that the 4th one would hide the support board. After that, secure the pickets right next to each other to enclose one full side. Follow the same process for the opposite side. Use the extra wood from the pickets for the front and back of the cabana. Cut these at a 15-degree angle on each side and measure the width as you go. Screw these in so that they are at the same height as the surrounding pickets. Do this only for the first 4 pickets on the front and back. Paint your cabana. I'd originally planned on using a can of exterior paint, but I didn't have a roller, and we are avoiding non-essential store trips right now. I had some Rust-oleum Solstice Blue on hand, and I love the way it turned out. The spray paint went on super fast, and I was done painting the entire cabana in only minutes. Finally, dress it up. Fairy lights, lanterns, container plants, grass baskets, throws, pillows, and a fruity snow cone treat are only a few ideas that will help you create a beachy feel to your backyard cabana. On the Fly DIY.